Hi, I'm Shreyas, currently a research scholar at IIT Indore. So today's topic is how to write thesis in LaTeX. Now, before going into the topic, at first, I would like to take this opportunity to thank the workshop organizers, Chief Advisor Dr. Raj, and my close friend and workshop coordinator Sonu Lamba for their efforts for this noble cause at these difficult times. And also I would like to thank all the participants who have taken part in this session. Now, without wasting our time further, let us discuss today's topic. Now, what is the plan? So the plan for today's session is that, and in the beginning I will show you the basic structure of the thesis, right, which contains a title page, which contains table of contents, it contains certificates, it contains chapters, right, then it contains bibliography, which is a very important a part of any thesis. So we are going to see a basic structure in the beginning. So that is the first thing which we are going to do. Once we have seen the basic structure, what I am going to show is two examples. One example is of my own thesis, which I did when I was in master's. And the second example is where I have obtained that thesis template from online. Okay, I will tell you the reference. And at the end also, I will give the references from where I have collected these things. And also I will talk about Overleaf and LaTeX, right? I have been using LaTeX from last 3 years, and I will talk more about this towards the end. So now let us begin about how to, you know, have a proper structure for a thesis in LaTeX. So now I'm using Text Studio. So let us take a new file, right? And here I choose wizards, quick start, right? See, thesis is a document which is really big in the sense the number of pages are more, right? So when you have a document whose number of pages are more, then we usually choose either report or book. Right. So I'm going with the report, you know, you can also try with book. And Sarah, when you are choosing book, okay, you have to remember that there are several options you get, okay, which I will be explaining you as I go on. So now we are choosing report, right? So yeah. Okay. So this is what it looks like, right? So here the document class. So this is what we call as preamble, right? So preamble. Here the document class is a report, right? Then these are packages, right? Okay. So you can always go and analyze, okay, why is this package is used, right? Like graphics, okay, whenever you want to include images, you should make sure that you are including this package. So all those things are there, which I'm not going in detail, right? So now, for example, if I want to say, start with the title page. So let me start with title. So say I just write thesis, then yeah. Okay, now here it is title. Sorry. Yeah. So thesis. So now here I will use a command called as make title. I will tell you what exactly this does. Let us save this file. Save as. Okay, let me save it on the desktop. Okay, in a new folder. Okay, let us give the name of the folder as say thesis writing. Okay, so yeah, so now let me run this program and see. So this is the first title page. Okay, using a make title command, I have written a title page for the thesis. Now you see the it is fairly simple. Okay, it is the simplest title page you can ever find for any thesis. You have to write multiple things, you know, like you have to write the supervisor's name, everything. Okay, a lot of things comes into this, or you might also interested in including the image of or the logo of your institution, right? So on and so forth, right? So many things are going to come. So how are we going to include those things in the make title? Of course, see what happens in the make title command. It is a predefined, you know, suppose like, you know, if I just keep my cursor on it, it will show the things, right? What are the things the make title does? One of the things is, so the whenever you want to, it's an inbuilt code, which you can think inbuilt command, okay, which generates a title on a separate title page, right? So this is what make title does. The disadvantage, I won't say disadvantage, I would say drawback of using make title is, you will not have a freedom to write title page as you wish. Okay, so make title has its own way of writing if things, right, in the title page. So because of this drawback, right, we can use a command called as begin title page. Okay, which I have actually written it already. So let me just copy paste it, right? I will just explain you all the things once I, okay. Let me, yeah. So if I run this now, let me see. Okay, so I have to actually include a graphic. So actually I have included an image here. So let me include that image also, right? I should actually save this image into that file. Otherwise this won't run, right? So for that, let me go to the desktop. Okay, so actually the file, the image is in this file. Let me copy it, and thesis writing is the file where I'm doing. So I have pasted it. Now let me run this. Yeah, so you see, this is the thesis title page. This is the main title page, right? So you see the difference, okay, when I'm using, actually see, here also I can add, if I want, inside this make title also, actually I can add all the images, right? I can do that. But when it comes to, you know, using this like huge command, you know, all like vertical spacing, this make title won't allow such a freedom, right? So for that, what I can do, see, this is a better option. What I did, slash begin title page. Okay, you have started, then slash begin center. You are saying that everything you write should be in center. Then you are saying huge, and in bold, you have to write thesis title, whatever your thesis title is. Then in large, you are writing thesis subtitle. You have given a vertical space of 0.5 centimeter. Then you are writing author name, right? See, author name. Then you are vertical fill. Vertical fill we use when we want to properly, you know, in a proportionate way, we have to fill things in a single page. We use vertical fill. Then thesis presented by so and so for Doctor of Philosophy, all those things you can write. Then vertical space. Then I'm including the graphics. So this is the institution logo, my institution logo. And in the same way, you can include your institution logo, department name, you know, university name, country, date. Okay, so these kind of things can be done, right? So you see, when I'm using a make title, of course, here, you know, whatever I want, I can write here, you know, the things. But when you write with a begin title page, you have a lot of freedom, okay, to tweak the things according to your wish. So that is what I want to tell you at first, right? So this is about the title page. Of course, you can go on and see your own ways of, you know, you can be more creative than what I am, and you can come up with your own title pages, right? So that is always there, okay? That is always there. But I think this will do, right? This will always do. Okay. Now, once I'm done with the title page, the second thing which I want to discuss is about the table of contents, right? Okay, so for table of contents, what we do is that I use this command slash table of contents. Yeah, here it is. Okay, so then a basic structure, right? How does, what are the things it has? It will have, say, introduction, right? Slash chapter. Okay, it has, it will have introduction. Okay, then say, okay, slash chapter. Okay, it will have, say, literature review. Literature review, right? Which is also very important for a thesis. Then it might have chapter where your main results will come, right? Your main results, whatever you have come up with. Then you have a chapter where, you know, I would say conclusion. Bibliography, I'm keeping it for the end. I will tell you what to do with that. So now you see, suppose if I am running this, running this code, yeah, I'm going to see, okay, chapter, first chapter, second chapter, you get a content, right? You also have all these things are there. Now, there are a few things which needs to be tweaked, right? So what are the things? You see, the page numbering is start from the this table of contents, which usually is not the case. When you are dealing with, if you even see any book for that matter, what happens is that you usually don't get page number starting from the table of contents, right? Actually, page number starts from the first chapter, right? So how do you deal with it? So how do you change this? So for that, what we do is here in the case of table of contents, after this page style, what we have to, this page style is empty. So if, when I am going to give like this, that makes sure that here the page number doesn't start. Now here what I do here in this slash page numbering Arabic, right? Okay, so now what happens, you see the, okay, so when I'm running it, see the chapter, it is starting from one. Here also it started from one. Then after that, what I can do is, actually, usually even it happens that, you know, the first page won't have page number if you have noticed in book. So again, you can use the same command that this page style is empty here, so that you will get all those things. So that is there. That is one thing. Okay. Now there is one more thing which we have to notice here. That is, if you have seen here, introduction, literature review, main results, conclusion. Fine. But when you are writing a thesis, what happens? Just after the title page, you, content won't come. Okay. There are several documents which comes in between. You know, you have like a approval sheet, certificate, declaration, many things comes between title page and content, right? So I'm going to add one such page now. So what I do after the title page, okay, I will write this, okay, slash begin center end center in this slash section. Okay, here I write approval of thesis or declaration of thesis, anything, right? So yeah, let us see this. So approval of thesis or declaration of thesis, when I add star here, there will be no numbering as such. Now here also you see the numbering, page number is coming, which I don't want. So for that I say that slash this page style is empty. Okay, and actually I will start, then there is one more thing I have to slash page numbering. I will start with Roman. So I will tell you, see, okay, I will remove this command. Okay, so what I have done now is that, you see, the page numbering, I'm starting with a Roman, and here this approval of thesis should come in content, but it should come before introduction. So what I will do here, I use a command called as slash add contents line to table of content, then section, then approval sheet or declaration state. Let me bold it. So now wait a minute. Yeah. So what happened now? This is the first page, which is approval of thesis, which has approval sheet with a Roman I got, right? See, all the pages which you write before content will be numbered as a with Roman, right? Whatever you write after introduction, starting from the introduction page from chapter 1, it will be with a 1, 2, 3, right? So here it is Arabic, then previously it was Roman, right? So that is how we properly write content page. So this is very important. So this you have to know. Now, as I said, one of the important part of any thesis is the reference section, right? Bibliography. So there are two ways of writing bibliography. One of the way is that you write / begin the bibliography, say 100, then you / bib item 1. So now when I run this, okay, so I can write anything here now, right? I can write the name of the author, right? Then his the journal where it is published, page number, everything, right? So this is one way of doing it. But here you have to write all the things on your own, right? I will show you a very simpler version of writing bibliography. So for that, let me at first remove this, right? There is something called as bib file, okay? So what is a bib file? If I create a bib file, it is very easy to import whatever I have in that bib file. So how do you create a bib file and what a bib file is, right? So let me show you an example of a bib file. Okay, let me take this example where, okay, sample bib, yeah. So let me open a bib file for you to show how does that look. Yeah, so here is the bib file. Okay, so here is the bib file and how it looks like. So here you have article, okay, then book, then misc. Let me completely copy it, right? Let me open a new folder, Control N, paste it. See, this is how a bib file will look like. You have article. This is Einstein, is the citations. Like when you want to cite, you have to use this, right? Einstein. I will tell you when I'm writing. So you just see, this is how a bib file looks, where you are mentioning about the author, title, journal, volume, page number. For book, it is, it will be like this. For any misc, if you want to give reference for online things, then it will be like this. So this is basically how a bib file looks. Okay. So where do I get these things, right? I will tell you. See, for example, when you are going to give reference to any of the journal paper, then you will get this kind of bib, right? I will show you. Before that, let me run this. Let me show you how to run this, right? How to include this in our main file. So once you have this kind of data with you, once you have these kind of things, we have to save it. Control save, Control S. So we have to save. Let me save it as bib.bib. See, okay. Let me save it as reference. Reference.bib. See, here I have to save it in .bib format. In the same file, right, where I wrote thesis. Okay, let me save it. So then you see the color changes. Now what I do here, in this case, here I will write / bibliography. At first, bibliography style. So here, UNSRT. This is unsorted. See, there are different bibliography styles, which I am going to discuss with you later. Now, for time being, you just remember UNSRT means unsorted. / bibliography, and here bib file. I have to give bib file. So here the bib file, which is that, this is the bib file reference. Okay, now in the conclusion, let me write few things and give it as a, okay, this document is an example of BibTeX, right, using in bibliography management. Okay, management. So now here I will cite one. Okay, here others the citation work, I can't give cite one. The first is Einstein, right? So this is Einstein. This whatever I write here, I should write it in the here, control V, then comma / cite. Then here the second one is LaTeX Companion. Actually, I will tell you the references from where I took all these things. Okay, then comma / cite. Okay, then here Knuth website, control C, control V. Okay, let us run it. Okay, the program is running. Yeah, see what have done till now. See, everything which was there in our bib file, right, reference bib file, has appeared, right, in our main file. See, all these citations have come, right? So what exactly I have done? So I wrote all the references in a separate file, called it as bib, and using these two commands, / bibliography style unsorted and / bibliography reference, which is the name of the file, I have called all those references to our main file. That's what exactly I have done. Now you might think, okay, this is just like, you know, you are complicating things instead of just writing / begin the bibliography and just writing. Why are you doing all these things? Why am I doing? Because suppose I let me open a random, like, you know, like suppose a journal paper on say support vector machine. Okay, suppose I take a support vector machine IEEE. So when I go and see here in any of these documents, what happens is I will go for this cite this. When I go for cite this, here you see BibTeX will be there. You just see already it will be given to you. You just have to copy it. Suppose if you want to add this paper in your thesis, just you copy that and come back to the reference bib file. Okay, paste it. Let me rename it as try and just run it once. Let me come to main file. Here I will write cite try. If I run this, okay, just a minute. Cite try. Yeah, see, that is coming here also, right? I could have done here also if I want to cite slash cite try, right? That's it. This will also cite here, right? This is also has cited. This also has cited. So you see, if I want to include some things here, what I did not even write this first complete IEEE, all these things. I just copied it to my reference.bib. Here I have copied. And here in the first, I gave the name for citation, okay, slash cite, what I want to write inside that. I want to write try. So that's what I gave. So this is a much easier way of doing things in bibliography, right? Adding things in bibliography, sorry. So this is a much simplified version. Whenever you go to a paper, you always, most of the times, get that citation thing. You just copy paste it in your reference file, which is stored as bib, right? It will appear in your bibliography. So this is a very important and, you know, interesting tool. Okay. So that is what I want to say. So now, till now, what we have done, we have actually completely, you know, we have done a title page, then content page, then introduction. Then I discussed about how to include some other tech file, tech document to your file, right? To your main file. Then I discussed about how to add bibliography, right? How to about bib tech files, right? So that's what I have discussed. Now I'm going to show you two of my own example, right? Where, you know, like this is the thesis which I have done in my master's. Of course, I could have done it a lot better, the way the presentations and everything. If I see now, it's okay, not this one. Wait a minute. I will show you the thesis which I wrote during my MSc. This is there in the report. Let me open it. Let me run it. Okay. Okay, let me run it. Yeah, see, so this is the title page which I have done. Actually, see, this title page, of course, you know, I don't think so it's really good looking, because this template was given to us from the university itself. Sometimes they give their template, you just have to add the content, right? So that is also one of the way of doing, right? You have already a template. So this is the template which was given to us. Of course, I could have done better, but this was, I think, 2-3 years back, right? So yeah, this was, you know, the title page. After that, approval, then comes the declaration, certificate, acknowledgement. Okay, so let me show you the code also here. Okay, you use all these, you know, packages. Then for theorems and corollaries, you are using these kind of things. Then, you know, this, you are using begin center, like you are doing everything, all the first title page, you are doing it, like how much vertical space you want, how much horizontal space you want, everything you are giving, then logo of the institution. So these things, you see, in the case of here also, you know, for the content here, you, all these things are, you know, Roman, then here you have Arabic, right? So this is how the content page should look like. And, you know, you have sections, subsections, everything. When you write slash table of contents, everything will come here. You don't have to worry about that. Then list of figures, whichever you are using. So all those things, then chapter one, chapter two. The way I have written bibliography, if you see here, the way I have written bibliography, it is like, see, everything I have written in a single document. And you see how much big it looks, right? I mean, if I want to change something, I have to go to that place and change. If I have divided it into multiple files, it would have been much easier for me to come back and change things according to the necessity. So here the bibliography bib item, see, this is how I have done, right? And you see the output, if you have seen, this is how it looks like. But in this, what I did, I wrote a separate bib file, then I called that bib file. So here, this is what I have done, and this looked much better, right? So this is what my thesis was, right? You know, like you have separate chapters like this. This was the code, right? And yeah, this is a last example which I am going to share with you, where, okay, this thesis example I found online when I was doing some research about what to teach and everything. I got this thesis. Let me open that. I think this is main.txt. Yeah. So this is a thesis which was by a professor named, I will tell you, let me open the file here. Yeah. So Saiwal, right? So this is GitHub Saiwal latex thesis. So from here, I downloaded the entire code in a download zip format. And here, if you see the thesis title, you see this is how the title page looks like. What he has done, he has defined its own class called as thesis. Okay. Actually, he has defined his own thesis class where he has defined how you have to, you know, how much the page setup and everything, it is well defined there. I will show you actually in that file. I will go and show you. Let me show you that. So here, if you go and see thesis class, right? Here the author has done a wonderful job of, you know, defining his own things. You see on the base class of book, he is defining everything. What should be the margin length? What should be the spacing between these things? And about, you know, example theorems, everything, whatever was there, you know, whatever is necessary. He is defining everything, right? He is defining. Then he is calling that. So that is also one way of doing it, which I think is not that much necessary. If you have a template given by institution, it is well and good. So you see, you have, and there is one more thing here, graphics path, he is giving pictures slash. So what is this? He is saying that whatever the pictures you are taking, you take it from this folder called as pictures. So he made a separate folder called as picture, separate folder called as chapter, separate folder called as appendices, and he is calling or including, when he includes all these things, suppose here, I can show you in this, whenever he includes, from that folder, like for example, here you see, let me open that slash include command, slash input. So he's using, there is a difference between input and include, more or less. I mean, you know, you can use alternatively. So he is using chapter one, you input chapter one from the folder chapter. So this is how you do it, right? So, I mean, you can go and see this. And you see the content page also, you know, you can, it looks much nicer. So you can tweak and, you know, you can do all sort of things by your own, right? So this can be done. I am actually this, for this, again, as I said, it's available online. You can also go and download it. So it is available in GitHub. So this is what the link is, GitHub / Saiwal / latex thesis. From here you can get. Now before, so these are the two examples which I wanted to show you. Now, before ending, I would like to show you the references from where I have taken all these things. One is the Overleaf, where it is given how to write latex, right? How to write thesis in latex, very nicely explained, you know. You have some available videos also, which you can see. So all those things are there, you know, which are very useful. And I would suggest you to go and see that. And in bibliography, as I said, you know, there are several, we have used unsorted, right? We have used unsorted style. There is a plain style. There is IEEE TR style. Like that, you can see all these things for your own, right? So all these things are available in Overleaf. It's a very good source, you know, from where you can know things. So that's always there. You can explore many things on your own. Now, before ending the session, one thing which I want to tell you is that all these things, I mean, when it comes to this learning later, okay, it's more about doing things on your own, right? So when you do things on your own, you learn a lot. So I would definitely ask all the viewers to go and explore things on your own, right? Contents are available in Overleaf, in Stack Exchange. In all these places, you can get multiple contents, you know, and you can be more creative and you can try things on your own. So having said this, I would like to once again thank all the people who have involved in this workshop, right, to make this happen. Okay, so this is a very good opportunity for all of us to share our knowledge. So I would like to thank the course coordinators for giving me, for workshop coordinators for giving me this opportunity. Thank you once again. Hope you have all learned something. Thank you.